Hello students, today we will start with the second book of your syllabus, that is Indian Economy. We have the first chapter, Indian Economy on the Eve of Independence. Over 200 years, the British government ruled Indian economy, and during this phase, there are huge changes on the Indian economy. So before starting with the current situation, let's look back, what was the condition of Indian economy during British rule? So before the colonial rule of British government, Indian economy was agricultural based economy. It was well known for its handicraft work. Exporter of goods. And we were having a flourishing economy. Before British rule. So basically most of the population was engaged in agricultural work. That's why it was agricultural based economy. We were world known for our handicraft work, especially the cotton work and the muslin cloth were exported in other countries. So we are well known for our goods in the world, and due to all these reasons, the Indian economy was flourishing. It means that we were having huge resources, and the demand of those resources in the international market was very high. Because of that, there was an inward flow of wealth in our country. But after the British rule, there was a huge change in these characteristics. So, again, at the British rule, we were agricultural based economy. They become an exporter of raw materials. And importer of finished goods. And the Indian economy became a stagnant economy during British rule. So after the British rule in India, we were still an agricultural based economy, that most of our population was engaged in agricultural work, but the condition of agricultural sector was very poor under British rule. Second one is, we were exporter of raw materials. Earlier also we were exporting goods to other countries, but the thing was that we were exporting not only raw materials but also finished goods and handicraft to the other countries. But during the British rule, we become an exporter of raw materials, and those raw materials are especially being exported to England. Most of the volume and most of the volume of export was to England. We become importer of finished goods. What Britishers used to do that, they used to import raw materials from India, and then they convert them in finished goods, and then they export it to our country. So because of these two factors, there was drainage of wealth from our country. There was drainage of wealth due to these two factors, because obviously the cost of raw materials will be less than the cost of finished goods. The last point, due to all these reasons, the Indian economy wasn't stagnant one. There was no growth in GDP of the country. There was very low per capita income. The growth rate was around 2%, and the per capita income growth rate in per capita income was around 0.5%. So which was very low for a flourishing economy, which was before the British rule. In this chapter, we will be studying various sectors of Indian economy to have an overview of Indian economy during the British rule or on the eve of independence. The first sector which we will be going to study is the agricultural sector, in which we are knowing the economical background of the farmers and the person who are engaged in agricultural work. The second sector is industrial sector, in which we'll be studying what was the condition of handicraft industry and what efforts have been taken by the Britishers for this sector. The third sector is foreign trade, in which we'll be studying the volume and direction of foreign trade during the British rule. The fourth sector is demographic structure, where we'll be studying about the health condition of the country, as well as the birth rate, death rate, and other aspects of demographic structure. The fifth sector will be the occupational sector. You are knowing that at the time of British rule, it was agricultural based sector. But what was the composition that we'll be going to study in this sector? The last one is the infrastructure or the communication sector, in which we'll be going to study what was the efforts that were being taken by the British government to enhance the infrastructure of the country, and what was the benefits of those changes to the people of the country and to the British government. So that will be the basic course of this chapter.